Hey guys. So today I am making this awkward little journal page, taking a little inspiration from a new plant I got the other day. I got this pretty little purple shamrock and I'm really excited about it. But anyway, Valerie sent me a surprise package and inside was this masking fluid by Winsor & Newton. Which is so nice, you didn't have to do that. Thanks so much. I've never actually used masking fluid before, which is kind of hilarious because I've used watercolor for such a long time. It was one of those things that I always kind of meant to do and try out, but I just never got around to it, or I just never... This is one of those things that I would just put in my cart in case I needed to get free shipping on Amazon or something like that. And so I'm playing with that today. So on this page, I'm painting an anglerfish. And the oxalis is coming out of his mouth. And it's supposed to be kind of like growing out of his belly. It sort of looks like he's just eating it, but... Anyway, so the plant is coming out and it's reaching for the light. I also heard that the masking fluid is really bad for your paintbrushes. But I didn't really know anything about masking fluid, so... I guess it's a good thing I just went for the dip pen instead, because I'm so bad at washing brushes. It's also kind of awesome because the dip pen can do such tiny lines as well. So I'm actually pretty excited about how much time I could actually save using masking fluid instead of painting around stuff all the time as I usually do. So I applied the fluid to his teeth, a little bit of light in his eye, and on the end of the angler. I also painted some tiny dashes in his fins, and I also blocked out the stems in the shamrock because I thought that that would be the greatest benefit to me, is not having to paint around those tiny things. I think the hardest part of using it though is not being able to heat dry my paint. It doesn't actually take that long to dry at all. It takes probably less time than the watercolor itself, but I do get kind of impatient when I'm super low on time, you know, because you go to work all day and you come home and you only have a little bit of time in the evening to do anything creative, and so I don't like to have to wait for my layers to dry, so just kind of holding off on that for a few minutes instead of going straight to the heat gun was a little bit difficult. But yeah, and then after I did the first layer, I put more masking fluid on again over top of the background wash. And that sort of opens up so many possibilities because I can get so many different layers of masking. I think the first time I ever heard about masking fluid, I want to say like grade 4, and we were in the school library and we were watching a little demo from this book illustrator. So she did kids' books, and she did the illustrations in watercolor, and she told us about how watercolor works, and she told us about the masking fluid. Of course, at the time, we called it Frisket. I don't know if that is completely different, or if it's just another word. But yeah, it's just, I don't know why that memory just seared itself into my brain all this time, and I think about it all the time. I don't know why. Like, it must have really left a mark on me, because now I'm doing... watercolor, and I'm doing it in such an illustrative style. It's kind of like, you know, even back then, it's sort of something that I guess I was just meant to do. I don't know. I just want to thank you again, Valerie. You guys don't have to send me stuff. Jeez. I have like such a horrible guilt complex. I can't handle it. Yeah, and hope you have a great time, and I'll see you next time. Bye.